Hello dear students, welcome to the mathematics class. So here we continue the chapter ratio and proportion. So in that exercise 12.1, let us see the next question. 12 main. Cost of a dozen pens is rupees 180 and cost of 8 ball pens and cost of 8 ball pens is rupees 56. Then find the ratio of the cost of a pen, to the cost of, ball pen. So here see, cost of dozen pens is rupees 180 and cost of 8 ball pens is 56 rupees. Then find the ratio of cost of a pen to the cost of ball pen. Cost of a pen means cost of one pen to the cost of one ball pen. But here you are given cost of dozen pens and cost of 8 ball pens. We don't know that cost of one pen and cost of one ball pen. So first you need to find that cost of one pen and cost of one ball pen. So here it is, cost of one pen, which is equal to total amount, how much? 180. And how many pens are there? Dozen. Dozen means 12. So divide the total amount by the number of pens, you will get the cost of one pen. So 12 ones are, 1. How much remains? 6. That will become 60. 12 paisa 60. That is 15 rupees. So cost of one pen is 15 rupees. Similarly, cost of one ball pen. So cost of 8 ball pens is 56. So divide the total cost by the 8, means number of total pens. So 8 ones are 8 7. So 7 rupees. So here it is, cost of pen and cost of ball pen. Now find, we can find the ratio. Therefore, ratio of cost of pen to the cost of a ball pen. So which is equal to cost of a pen, how much is there? 50 divided by cost of ball pen, 7. So we can divide these two, therefore the ratio is 50:7. So this is about the solution of 12th question. Let us the next question, 13th one. Consider the statement, ratio of breadth and length, is 2:5. is 2:5. And complete the following table.
Find the fraction of Sheila first.
fraction of Sheila. So H is equals to in that total parts, how many parts you should give? 3. And next, fraction of Sangeeta. So in that total parts, how many parts you should give? 2. That is 2/1. So these are the fractions of Sheila and Sangeeta. Now in that 20 points, how much you should give to this Sheila? That is 3/5 of the 20 pence we should give. 3/5 of means multiplication, means 3/5 into 20. You will get the how much pence Sheila will get. Fraction of Sheila is now 3/5. So we should give 3/5 of 20 pence to this Sheila. So that means 3/5 into 20. Therefore, number of pence we should give to Sheila. We should give to Sheila, which is equal to 3/5 of 20 pence. So here it is, 5 ones are 5 4 are 20, so 3 into 4, so 12 pence we should give to Sheila. Similarly, number of pence we should give to Sangeeta. So how many pence we should give to Sangeeta? 2/5 of 20 pence, means 2/5 into 20. So 5 ones are 5 4 are, so 2 into 4 8. Let us see, if you add this you will get 20 or not, 12 plus 8 20. So we should give 12 pence to Sheila and 8 pence to Sangeeta. So for finding or dividing the something between the given ratio, in the given ratio you should first find the total parts and then find the fraction. So multiply that fraction to the total thing, then you will get the how much you should give to that. So this is about the solution of 14th question. We'll see the next question. Okay, let us see next question. 15th one. Mother wants to divide rupees 36 between her daughter Shreya and Purvika in the ratio of their ages. If the age of Shreya is 15 years and Purvika is 12 years, find how much both will get. So mother wants to divide rupees 36 between her daughters in the ratio of their ages. Here they are not given ratio. You need to find the ratio first. The ratio of their ages you need to find. So first find the ratio, then find the total parts and find the fraction, then you will get the amount. So here a ratio of age of Shreya to Bhumika means age of Bhumika. So which is equal to age of Shreya is 15 years divided by age of Bhumika is 12 years. So which is equal to 3 5s are 3 4s are. So 5/4, that is the ratio is 5:4. So now, so total parts will become how much? 5 plus 4, 9. So total parts which is equals to 5 plus 4, 9. Therefore, fraction of Shreya. Will become how much? Total parts are 9. In that, how many parts we should give? 5 parts to the Shreya. So, 5 by 9. Similarly, fraction of Bhumika. So, which is equals to total parts are 9. In that, how many parts we should give to Bhumika? 4 parts. So, therefore, amount for Shreya. How much? 5/9 of the total amount. 5/9 of 36. So amount for Shreya. So 5/9 of 36 rupees. In that total amount, how much we should give? 5/9 of the 36. We should give to the Shreya. So 9 1 4. So 5 into 4. So 20 rupees. Similarly, amount for Bhumika. So which is equal to? What is the fraction? So 4/9 of 36 rupees we should give to Bhumika. So 9 1 4. So 4 4 16. Mother should give 20 rupees to the Shreya and 16 rupees to the Bhumika according to their ratio of their ages. So this is about the solution of 15th question. Now let us see next question, last question of this exercise, 16th one. Present age of father is 42 years and that of his son is Present age is 14. Then, when son was 12 years old, then father would be of 40 years. So, here 14 years, so 2 years less. So, in that father, total years also, make 2 years less. What do you get? 40 years. So, write, when son was 12 years old, then father was 40 years old. When son was 12 years old, then father was 40 years old, because present age is 42 years. Present age of his son is 14 years. So 12 years means, so subtract 2 from this, you will get 12. Again subtract 2 from this, you will get 40. That means when son was 12 years old, then father was 40 years old. Now find the ratio. So here now, father age to his son age. Father age how much? 40 divided by son age 12. So how much you get here now? 4 3 4 10. That means 10 by 3 and the ratio 10:3. So next, see age of father after 10 years. Age of father after 10 years to the age of son after 10 years. To the age of son after 10 years. So here present age of father 42 years and present age of his son 14 years. Then after 10 years, what will be the age of father? 52 years. And what will be the age of his son? 24 years. So first find the age of